What's going on, Spice Lords? Lilith here, and we have a much-requested, exciting new part of the Advanced Guide series. This video is going to be addressing Blight's flicks, namely the 90, 180 shoulder flick, and how to pull them off sharply and perfectly every time. So first off, let's define exactly what a flick is. A flick is defined as a sudden, quick movement, and in Blight's case, they're snappy lunges that curve around corners, objects, and loops to hit survivors in spots they thought they were safe in. Plus, they're extremely fun to pull off. Before we go any further, I just want to clarify that this guide is designed for both PC and console players. All of the strategies we use to get tighter flicks will work on controllers too, and I do have some footage of it later on. The biggest mistake most people make when they try to flick is the timing of the hit itself. Most people believe that you press the attack button and then start moving in a direction. This isn't quite the case, and the problem with this is that you're going to end up curving 90 degrees in sort of like a quarter circle shape. The trick is to begin moving in the direction you want to flick just before you press the button. Wait until Blight has reached his maximum turn rate and then click, continuing the movement until you land the hit. Let me give you a couple quick examples of how this looks in practice. This first example was done with no pre-turn at all, so our velocity starts late and therefore causes us to curve really wide. In this second example, we do a slight turn before we commit to the lunge, and you can clearly see this gives us a way snappier and cleaner flick. The next question I get asked pretty often, which some of you are probably thinking of right now, is why do I look down when going for a flick? A lot of this is muscle memory, to be honest, but there is some science to it. Similar to the hug tech, looking down reduces Blight's ability to bump into an object, which allows us to get closer to an object without colliding, and therefore turn more before going for a flick. This is much more important on a 180 flick, but it's a really good practice to try on a 90 as well. 180 flicks are slightly more tricky to land, and you need to make sure you've gotten down the technique to do clean 90s before you attempt these. Effectively, a 180 is just a 90 degree flick with a 90 degree pre-turn on top, so when you approach an object you want to 180 around, you'll need to start turning a little bit earlier than you would with an ordinary flick. This is going to take some practice, as you might end up bumping into the side of an object you're trying to flick around. Practice this by running parallel to things like cars. Position yourself a short distance away from the object and start turning about half a second before you'd reach the end where you want to start the flick. Combine this with the technique we discussed earlier about the 90 flick, and you should be hitting some nasty 180s in no time. The next one, and possibly one of the most misunderstood, is the shoulder flick. I gave it that name as it has very similar muscle memory to the shoulder bump, which you can learn about in my Blight guide. Effectively, when Blight first starts his flick, he has a huge hitbox that only exists for a few frames, and then it changes to a much longer and thinner one. This extended lunge is what most survivors find very easy to dodge in the open, so we need to focus on the first one. To pull off a shoulder flick, you're going to need to run up to a survivor and wait until you're physically touching them before you start your attack. You should be able to feel yourself start to glide on their cylindrical hitbox. It's tricky to get down the timing at first, but eventually you'll start to get a feel for it. After this, you're going to want to start to flick in either the left or right direction to rotate your huge initial hitbox into a spot that they cannot escape from. When done correctly, you can almost have the survivor slightly behind you or off screen, and it still connects. It just takes some practice and timing. This is the same advice I give for people who struggle with survivors who wiggle, meaning they move back and forth in sort of like a zigzag pattern to try and force your hitbox to change and miss. If you feel like you haven't quite gotten close enough to their hitbox in your first rush, don't worry too much about continuing forwards to bump into something else. Turn around and try again until you've guaranteed that hit. As far as where you can pull off a 90 or 180, the possibilities are quite literally limitless. Try and experiment, go for some insane shots around corners, over jumps, through doorways, or any other kind of crazy ideas you can come up with. These are the parts that make Blight so fun, so practice them and go crazy. It is tricky, but feel free to come and hang out with us live on Twitch if you have any further questions, as I'd love to help you guys out. Stay tuned for the next episode in the Advanced Guide series. Remember, you're doing awesome today, and we'll have a ton of great videos releasing soon. Stay spicy, and I'll see you all in the next one.